One of the things that our lab is specializing in is the development of cell-free synthetic biology systems. This is really important because it allows us to decouple cellular objectives from what engineering objectives might be. Imagine that I'm a cell living in the environment. My goal is not to produce insulin for you, it's not to produce a fuel for you, it's not to produce anything else. My goal is really to live and survive. And so rather than have to worry about keeping the cell alive, we basically take a living cell, we rip off the cell wall, and we collect the guts of the cell. So this is kind of like the machinery that might make the product we want to make, or it might sense a small molecule in the environment that we would like to sense.
So that can be really useful if you want to make, for example, a toxic compound that would normally kill a cell. Now you can take all the components of a cell that would make that compound and deconstruct it and then put it back together.
So you can kind of think of this like if you had a car and we're gonna basically open the hood up, take the engine out and put it over here and then play with it.
I think one of the powerful aspects of designing artificial cells is that we will be able to use and incorporate imaging molecules that might be helpful for us to detect disease, therapeutic drugs that might be helpful for us to treat disease, and we'll also be able to use these structures to move into extreme environments, high pH environments, high temperatures, to detect and respond to different biological compounds that we're interested in.